I've been asked to give you a very quick 5-6 minute overview, I think I just lost a minute, but anyhow, about luxury trends and the luxury client. And it's a difficult one to summarise that quickly, so I'm just going to highlight some points. You can't today define a product simply by labelling it luxury. And there are similarities within the luxury trends and luxury market and the luxury traveller. And they are usually like-minded travellers. They like to travel in a certain style and a certain way, and they do like luxury brands like that you see on the screen there today. So that you'll tend to find that there's this consistency with this style of traveller. They're also usually looking for something unique in their travel, in their plans. So this is just, it's not always necessarily the destination, and sometimes an event will drive what they want to do. So for an example, this is the Grand Prix in Monaco and the Cannes Film Festival. So the luxury traveller might be looking for something unique in that way so that they don't necessarily just it's solely driven by destination. And also I promise you I didn't Photoshop this ship in. We were there, but it's again what was driving this cruise and the results of the success of the cruise was being around on the ship for the Olympic Games. So I'm often asked, how do we target that luxury client? And this sometimes is exactly what we need to do. We need to be driving it by a unique opportunity. And the Olympics is one. There's so much talk about Gallipoli in 2015 and the anniversary. So those are already destinations and unique experiences. Destinations certainly without a doubt of interest to the luxury traveller. They want to be doing things as quickly as they can that perhaps they haven't ticked off the list. So this is just, I think, a perfect shot of with the Arctic with the polar bears. They want to be up close and personal. We're not going to put you in any danger, but they do want to be close enough so that they can actually feel they're part of that destination. And I think this is probably one of my favourite shots. And I think Abercrombie and Kent have been incredibly successful as a luxury operator for many years, that they've actually turned camping into fun. And let's face it, this is a bit the same thing. You know, I'm okay with the camping if I've got a nice accommodation to go back to, really good food and champagne. Of course, this is just a hint of a trip returning on a Zodiac with a chocolate-dipped strawberry and a glass of bubbles, just to help you get over the cold. So they also are going to look for personalisation whenever they travel. They're going to be looking for recognition. They like to be called by their names everywhere, personalised stationery. They are seamless travellers. In other words, they don't want to have to fuss. They're quite happy to outlay the money for what experience and uniqueness and the luxury touches that they perhaps believe they need or want, but they want it to be seamless travel. All of us in the cruise business provide seamless travel. It just depends on what level your clients want. I talked a little bit about destinations. They are very keen to get to the destinations that open up, Miramar, Cuba, any of those destinations that perhaps we have not had freedom of access to. We're very fortunate in the cruise industry whereby we can get you as companies to many of these destinations. Everybody knows about a blue-footed booby bird. There are red ones as well, but it's the Galapagos. So people want to get to these destinations, and we have a lot to thank in our industry of people like David Attenborough and his shows, because we learn a lot. You do need to become educated in these destinations, and you do need to be able to explain a little bit more than the blue-footed booby bird that the Galapagos has to offer. We all talk a lot about the destinations. That's not my family, by the way. That was very nasty up the back. So these are the sorts of things that your clients are going to want to get to and get close to and touch. And we've talked about destinations, but again, I think we're often asked, how do we get to this luxury traveller? And I think it's a combination of things. It's a combination of understanding uniqueness and opportunities like the film festival, like Gallipoli, the Olympics, the whole lot. So there's lots of things. And I think getting them into these destinations that are a bit unique. Sell the destination and then sell the touches that come with it. And just to summarise, I think you've got to understand that the luxury traveller today is looking for an understated elegance, but a value proposition in what they're spending. And it's not going forward. It's been interesting. I was reading a report from Beijing about from a marketing group, and they're actually trying to get their marketing people to describe luxury brands without using the word luxury, because it simply does not mean that if we tag you a luxury product that you are. And it's very different in everyone's minds as to what luxury actually is. So enjoy, and good luck with the luxury selling.